Hey fans, fighters, subscribers and YouTubers, and welcome to the most spectacular fighting show on YouTube, Fighters That Will Always Be Remembered. This show includes documentary stories of famous boxers, UFC fighters and K1 fighters that left an undeletable trail in their sport and should always remain known and famous for their achievements. Please follow episodes, send your propositions to my Facebook, and make sure that your fighter gets the next story.
Hello and welcome. In this show we're talking about Ronda Rousey, an American mixed martial artist, judoka and actress. She was actually the first UFC bantamweight champion, born as Ronda John Rousey, February 1st, 1987, from Riverside, California. Her nicknames are Rowdy, Baddest Woman on the Planet, and The Arm Collector, you know, pretty much. This reminds me of a movie, Bone Collector, you know, Ronda is a pretty much bit Bone Collector, Armbar Collector, residence Venice, California, nationality American. Height 5 foot 7 inches, weight 135 pounds, she has a reach of 168 centimeters style. Primary style is judo, but she actually has some premises of boxing, fighting out of Santa Monica, California, team Glendale Fighting Club, trainer Grappling Jean Lebel, Rainer Gracie, Gokul Chuchian, Anne-Marie Demars, boxing Edmund Tarverdian. She's 4th degree black belt in judo. Her mixed martial arts record is 13 matches, 12 wins, 3 by knockouts, 9 by submission, 1 loss via knockout. It will be talked about later. Rousey was born in Riverside, California, the youngest of three daughters from Anne-Marie Demars and Ron Rousey, after whom Rousey was named. Her mother's decorated judo career was the first US citizen to win a World Judo Championship. Her maternal grandfather was Venezuelan and was a part of Afro-Venezuelan ancestry. Her other ancestry includes English, Polish. She's pretty much a mixture. Her stepfather was an aerospace engineer, her biological father having broken his back sleeping with his daughters, and having learned that he would be a paraplegic, committed suicide in 1995 when Ronda was only 8 years old, unfortunately. Ronda had pretty much problems in her life for the first 6 years. She struggled with speech and could not form the intelligible sentence due to apraxia, neurological childhood speech disorder. With the sound speech disorder, and the consequences due to umbilical cord was wrapped around her neck at birth. Actually, Ronda dropped out of high school, later earned a GED. She was raised in Southern California in Jamestown, North Dakota, retiring from a judo career in 21. In the judo, she had many successes. She began judo with her mother at the age of 11. At 17, Rousey qualified for 2004 Olympic Games in Athens, becoming the youngest judoka in entire games. She won a gold medal at the World Junior Judo Championship in Budapest, Hungary. In April 2006, she became first female US judoka in nearly 10 years to win an A-level tournament. She went 5-0 to claim gold in Birmingham World Cup in Britain. February 2007, Rousey moved up to 70 kilograms when she was ranked as one of the top 3 women in the world. Silver at 2007 World Judo Championship, gold medal 2007 Pan American Games. Rousey competed also in Beijing 2008. She lost her quarterfinal due to Edith Bosch, qualified from bronze medal match, defeated Annette Bloem by Yuko to win a bronze medal. The victory, she became first American to win an Olympic medal in women's judo since its interception to an Olympic sport in 1992. Rousey had pretty much so many problems, she later decided to go to fight with the mixed martial arts, and this is the thing we'll be talking about right now. So, let's start about Ronda Rousey. In her first fight versus Adrienne Gomes, she won via submission armbar. The match lasted only 25 seconds in Arizona, California. I can only say that Ronda is known for this armbar, you know, this is pretty much a judo move. This armbar, you know, when you catch somebody's arm and when you extend it like this and you break here in the elbow. This is something that Ronda is known for, you see, this bone is broken. And Ronda actually is very, very known for this submission as a pretty much true judoka. In the second fight, won Charmaine Tweet submission armbar June 17, 2011. Believe it or not, only 49 seconds. Ronda was one of the fighters that were the fastest in submitting her opponents. She also had 3 amateur mixed martial arts record matches, but I don't think this is something that should be mentioned, really. Ronda defeated everybody really, really fast with her armbar. Later, Sara Diallo, technical submission armbar, only 25 seconds. Julia Budd submission, 39 seconds. What can I say? It was always armbar. Well, this is bantamweight debut, first fight, Miesha Tate. Well, Miesha Tate was a good opponent, I can't say. She really, really was a good opponent. March 3rd, 2012, she lost via armbar. Miesha Tate was defeated, 4 minutes 27 seconds in Columbus, Ohio. This was bantamweight debut. She won the bantamweight championship later versus Sarah Kaufman, also submission armbar. Only 49 seconds, sorry, 54 seconds in San Diego, California. I mean, Rosie became really, really much known with this move. This armbar, it was, you know, it could be annoying a little bit, but it was a move. It was a really, really strong move. It's something, when Ronda catches you on the ground, you have no chance of slipping out. Liz Carmouchet was also defeated via submission armbar February 23rd. You know this, with Liz Carmouchet, she was in pretty much solitary position. She went like this, and Ronda used an opportunity to move and transit with her, through her guard, and do an amazing armbar from here. It was something that was pretty much hard to be done. A later fight versus Miesha Tate, also rematch, also defended UFC Women's Bantamweight Championship. This armbar was the hardest one. All matches till then lasted one round. This match lasted 3 rounds. And Miesha Tate gave a really, really strong resistance. But in the end, Ronda was able to turn her over. She went for an armbar. Miesha tried to slip. And she went for a double armbar. She broke leg. She was trying to break arm in 2 places. And Miesha had to tap for the second time. Sarah McMahon. Well, this is the fight that is known. You know, Ronda first time used TKO. A knee to the body to knock someone down, and with Sarah McMahon this was the case. Sarah McMahon was knocked out, was TKO'd via knee to the body, and became really, really the first match of Ronda when she started to strike a little bit. She wasn't a pure judoka after this fight. Later victory over Alexis Davis, she was holding her via armbar and punching, and referee had to stop after 5 or 6 punches. July 5th, 2014, I mean, those punches were so brutal. Victory over Kat Zingano, submission straight armbar. This may be the shortest fight ever in the female in the female MMA. Only 14 seconds versus Alexis Davis was 16 seconds. Kat Zingano started strongly, but Ronda was able to flip her over, reverse her and hold her in the armbar. Really strong. And finish the fight. 34 seconds versus Beth Correa, KO punch, August 1st, 2015, defended the championship. Well, this is the time when Ronda Rousey started to strike, started to use striking as well. UFC 193. First defeat of Ronda Rousey. And what I said, Holly Holm is going to defeat her. I was very, very sure that they fought in Melbourne, Australia. I was very sure. If Holly Holm doesn't let Ronda Rousey take her down, Holly Holm is going to defeat her, you know. Southpaw stance, pretty much open hands. Holly Holm is a world-class striker. She was a boxing champion. She had amazing kicks. I mean, the best kicks in the female MMA. This is Holly Holm. Ronda Rousey was fighting bad from the beginning of this match. She was unable to do Holly Holm striking. She had no chance. And actually, Holly Holm was holding her on distance, doing strong left straights, and was able to defeat Ronda Rousey. Ronda Rousey fell from one strong strike of Holly Holm. Later, Ronda was rocked, tried to stand up, and the left high kick really sent Ronda to the ground. And the Holly hitted, two or three punches, referee had to stop the fight. And I can only say this was first defeat of Ronda Rousey. Whether Ronda is going to return or not, we're going to see about soon. This was fight of the night, two rounds. I can only say that I was a bit impressed with how Holly Holm easily defeated Ronda Rousey, because this was not something that I was expecting. About Ronda's personal life, we can only say she filmed a few movies, really, filmography. Honono, Taiku Kai TV, 2011-2014, The Expendables 3, she acted Luna, in Furious 7, she acted Kara, in Entourage, she was herself, in Roadhouse, her role is Lady Dalton. From personal life, Rousey was formerly a vegan, but describes her current diet as kind of mix between a paleo and warrior diet. She originally opposed using her nickname. Her friends gave her Rowdy, feeling it would be disrespectful to professional wrestlers. Rowdy Roddy Piper, after meeting Piper through Jeannie LaBelle, helped train both of them. Piper personally gave his approval. Rousey dedicated her successful title defense at UFC 190 to Piper, following his death on the previous day. Actually, she is a fan of professional wrestling, Dragon Ball Z. She has had a commercial partnerships, including Mobile Network, Insurance Agency, Insurance Reebok. Rousey became the first female ever to be guest of SportsCenter. But about her personal life, Ronda Rousey was having pretty much problems, because she revealed an altercation with her ex-boyfriend. She dubbed Snappers McCreepy, who had taken nude photos of her without her consent or knowledge. She discovered this shortly before her first Miesha Tate fight and admitted in her biography that she got very violent on him. She wrote, "I slapped him across the face so hard my hand hurt. I punched him in the face with a straight right, then a left hook. He staggered back and fell against the door. Then I grabbed him by the neck of his hoodie, kneed him in the face, and tossed him aside on the kitchen floor." Rousey once dated fellow UFC Brandon Schaub, but in August 2015, Rousey was rumored to be in a relationship with one more UFC fighter, Travis Brown, who knocked out Schaub in about the previous year. After a picture of the two appeared on Twitter, and Brown's estranged wife, Jenna Renee Weep, accused the two of seeing one another. Brown was at the time still married and under investigation at the UFC after Webb publicly accused him of domestic violence back in July. Brown confirmed he and Rousey were together in October 2015. The next day, Ronda Rousey publicly announced that she is dating Travis Brown. And about Ronda Rousey, I can only say that I hope that she will return.
Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe us on YouTube. Send us your propositions to make sure to see your favorite fighter in this show. Thanks, and see you all in the next episode.